So actually from a random picture or any picture you take, you can actually match it to, in very high probability, to a person, and then get his contact details and information pretty easily without knowing his name, without even knowing anything about him, just based on facial recognition.
Basically, that's the case.
Hey everyone, Yaniv Hoffman here with the new video, and I'm thrilled to welcome back Lina from Espy.
Hello.
Good to have you back, Lina. And if you missed Lina and mine video Nowhere to Hide episode, it's a must watch. I will leave it somewhere here or here, and definitely link in the description. And Espy develop an open source intelligence solutions both to government and now increasingly more to the public sector. And Lina gave us a fantastic tour last time on the platform, so I do urge you, if you didn't see it yet, you must see it. And today she's here with exciting updates, and without further ado, you know what, Lina, take it away and let us know what we are going to see today.
Thanks, Yaniv, for the introduction. We're going to talk about two things today. First is our capability to search by face. It is a very powerful technology that allows you to understand if someone is having duplicated your accounts across social networks, or if someone is using a photo of you or a photo of your closest in order to spread certain news, to have this additional accounts that you have no idea about, etc. Shall we try any with your photo?
Okay. Let's see if I have something to hide. So it's a facial recognition. You take a picture and then you search it in the web, right?
Exactly. We search across web 1 and web 2 with the image. It can be in two formats, can be a GPG or PNG.
So just when you say web 1 and web 2, it's like the surface web and the deep web.
It is the surface web, partially deep web, and web 2 is basically the social networks and other layers of the data that you need to authorize yourself before you have access to the information.
Okay, excellent. So let me take a picture. I'm arranging myself. Okay.
Well, the beauty of the technology is that you can even have glasses on or etc. We will still conduct the search. While it's in progress, we can discuss more on how this can help. Apart from the identification of the hidden accounts that you may not know about, that some other people might register under your name or using your photos, maybe different name, etc. It can also help with your additional request on the data. Let's say you want to check, as I mentioned, the closest, maybe your child, if someone is exploiting his images or her images, etc. You have here the status bar. At the moment, it so shows it's finished. Working with the technology of the facial recognition, it is very powerful and brilliant because it allows you from the image of the person to come to an identity, name, a link in the social network, articles, publications, etc. However, it's important to people to understand that a user of the system similar to ours should have all the legal basis to process this photo. Once you have the permission from the person, or once you conduct an investigation, or once you want to do it for yourself and your family members in order to make sure that this picture is not being used by a third party, you're completely fine with legal rights. But it's important to mention that it is not a technology that can be used by any person for, you know, any random citizen in order to receive some more information based on the face.
No, definitely, Lina, and it's very good that you emphasize it. We do not support and promote illegal activities. Everything needs to be for legal. We do it for educational purposes, and definitely this can help many companies and also individuals with their work and investigation, but under the law.
So let's see what you would get from it. So you have a photo, and here we go. Here we give a score on how system can be sure about this person on the link matches the photo that we have uploaded. So the highest 88, you can compare this to, or you can click on the link and you will jump to the source itself to understand what kind of information we get from there. So here we go. We have your LinkedIn post and your profile that generated it, and so on. So we have multiple links over here. Click on the link and go to the source. We do not own or control the links. We just search across the available data to bring from there the information that will have the same image or similar image on. Now here we go. I have a bunch of links. And Eve, you're a famous person, I need to say.
A lot in social media. Wow, this is a very old video.
Then those people that are a bit similar to you, but perhaps not you, will have a lower score. Those that system can confirm are yours will be mentioned as identical.
So actually from a random picture or any picture you take, you can actually match it to, in very high probability, to a person and then get his contact details and information pretty easily without knowing his name, without even knowing anything about him, just based on facial recognition.
Basically, that's
amazing.
One more thing that we also want to go in details, it is additional capability that is about understanding the person from a search by the name. This name can contain first and last name, or this name can contain a certain nickname of a person, etc. So what the system will be doing, it will be taking this specific name and searching across the similar layer of source, but it will indicate to you mentions of the person in the social networks, like posts that will have your name in and so on. It will bring you links, it will bring you social media accounts and images of the person. So we call it a quick scan. Yeah, here we go. We have some results already. This specific type of the search can show you a following thing. First of all, if your name is being unique or not, it will give you the score of uniqueness. It is good for companies to verify that the person is real. It's not some fake name that you just produced for fake registration. For example, you want to claim deliver. Yeah, you order something online and you want to receive a delivery at your door or at your block. And you create a fake account, you order this stuff, and then the company will ship, and maybe a person will never sign up for this delivery, will lose money on that. This specific type of the search will show you the score, whether this person name is real or not. Will this name match to a phone number or an email that the person have left as the contact details or not? If this matches, great. So the person is real, we can ship the good, we can receive some profit from this. If the person is not real, then we might lose money on it. And we are pretty good in this industry. We are saving a lot of money to small shops, to bigger companies, and so on this unreceived deliverables. So your score is unique. Congratulations, Yaniv. We can ship you everything you ordered.
But what does it mean, the 5.3 is unique out of what?
Out of 10. I would say it's a middle score of your name being unique. So there are not so many people with this name, but it is still a common name. It is not that created. You know, contact names related to you might be your colleagues, friends, family members, etc., closest friends, and so on. Your social network profiles, they do exist, and those they are. Web results mentioned about you, and posts having you tagged or mentioned, something that you generated or someone mentioned you, and so on. Again, also proves that there is some activity about you in the social networks, so we can verify you're a real person. And of course, photographs if we want, and we know what we can do then with this photograph. So this is it. A quick resume on the person having purely a person name and the capability to get social network accounts, web mentions on the person having purely a photograph.
So it's amazing. You can start from a picture because you want to know about this specific person and to investigate more. You get connection into a profile. So you get the name, then you search the name. You can reach colleagues, peers, friends, social media to verify it further. And I saw, Lina, when you opened the workflow or the filters, mm-hmm. There are much more. We spoke about the facial recognition, the name, but can you maybe share a bit more on the others, at least? No need to demonstrate,
yeah,
but
sure.
to show.
We can search by IPs of users. This will allow us to receive information about person's location to validate it. We can take the same commercial flow, or you register in the platform to receive certain bonuses or free trial or at least receive an access to services of the company. And your mentioned locations, country, or phone number does not match the IP. Lead search, it's a search that we can do by a keyword of the company, etc. And we can receive information from social network of posts having this name of the company in and what people say about this. Do they like it? Do they appreciate it? Do they share positive experience about cooperation with this company or this brand or this product or not? Mm-hmm. And so on. Also can be used, let's say you want to sell a certain product to an audience of X, yeah, and This would be filtered by a keyword. So you put the keyword in and you receive information. What are the people that communicate about this keyword? Email Search Pro. It's very powerful search by email. It will show you the correlations to social networks with this email. And again, you will have maybe a person's photo, a link to social media accounts and more. KYC validation is an instrument that allows you to validate companies based on companies' IBAN, VAT numbers, and the website. At the moment, the VAT and the IBAN works for US only. So before you make a transaction, you want to verify the company is real. Phone number detective. This is the most powerful thing that we have across, I believe, many vendors in the same field. Here we check more than a dozen apps and social network accounts in real time. And we receive multiple names that the person has. And what is very important, that those are the names that not only the person uses to call himself, but what other say about you, how others save your phone number. And it is extremely important. You can understand person's marital status, position at work, even some personal types of the personality. Yeah? If he was ever related to spam or whatever it is, many companies do check their customers for having potential relation to fraud. They will not interfere into the name, the last name, whatever. But if someone have been calling that person connected to fraud, those accounts would be deeper investigated or checked, etc., in order to save or preserve company's reputation. And yeah, it is a really great tool and completely powerful, completely GDPR compliant, and so on.
It's very strong. So at least a dozen of filter, right? From IP address geolocation to email to phone searches, faces, facial recognition that we saw, the telescope, Instagram, web collection, definitely strong tools.
Compromise social network ID request is also a strong one. It will tell you if your or the closest one social network IDs have been ever compromised. Means if there's a password leaked or if there's any email connected to your account leaked, etc. So you just put simply the ID, you choose which social network you want to check, and we'll check across if there's any information available about that. So you need to mind your own personal security, always change your passwords, and so on.
And what's the difference between if I'm being pawned to this one?
It's not many differences. I think we cover a little bit different part of the sources, I would say. But it is a similar functionality indeed. So right now, all of those features that you have seen here are available for free for you to try them. You go to our website and there is a button of Get Started. It will bring you automatically to a registration page. You need to use your phone number and your email in order to sign up. And you will have free trial for 2 to 5 quests based on the credits to try the system, to check on the great technology that you have.
Ah, cool. And I will add that in the previous video, and it's still account here, negotiated for 10% on the subscription fee if you like to register to subscribe to the service. And I will leave also on the screen and in the description the code for this additional discount. So definitely it's opportunity to check it out free, first of all. And if you like it, to subscribe and enjoy a better price. With that said, Lina, thanks a lot, and keep us updated if more cool features and tools will be released. And definitely, I will be more than happy to show it to the viewers.
Thanks, Yaniv. It was a pleasure to talk, as usually.
With that said, it was a short video, but very insightful, as always with Lina. If you like this kind of content, please leave your comments in the description. If you like the video, please like it. If you didn't, you can press the unlike button. If you are not a subscriber yet, check more of my videos. And if you feel that I can contribute or I'm doing a good job, please subscribe. It will only take a minute or less or seconds. And until the next video, see you.